TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 20th of November. National Register of Citizens to apply across country, says Interior Minister. Afghan government claims surrender of 600 Islamic State affiliates. And Bhutanese Foreign Minister visits renowned Buddhist temple in India. And now for all the details. India's Interior Minister Amit Shah told the Parliament on Wednesday that the National Register of Citizens, or NRC, the draft list validating genuine Indian citizens will be implemented nationwide. He said all citizens of India, irrespective of religion, will figure in the list.
India's Interior Minister Amit Shah on Wednesday told the Parliament that the National Register of Citizens, or NRC, a draft list validating bona fide Indian citizens, will be implemented nationwide. Shah informed the upper house of the Parliament that no person, no matter what religion he or she follows, needs to be afraid of the NRC process. The NRC aims to identify illegal immigrants, primarily from Bangladesh, who entered Northeast India and settled there after March 25, 1971, and to deport them to their native country.
NRC ki prakriya desh bhar mein hogi. Us waqt Assam ke andar bhi ye NRC ki prakriya swabhavik roop se fir se ki jayegi. Aur isme maine fir se spasht kar deta hu कि किसी की किसी भी धर्म के लोगों को कोई डरने की जरूरत नहीं है ये सारे लोगों को एनआरसी के अंदर समाहित करने की व्यवस्था है ही है
Around 1.9 million people were left off from the updated list of citizens released in northeastern Assam province earlier this year after a mammoth years-long exercise to check illegal immigration from Muslim majority Bangladesh The Interior Minister said in Parliament that people whose names are missing from the NRC can approach regional quasi-judicial bodies known as tribunals to prove their citizenship.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz leader Shahid Khaqan Abbasi has said that former Premier Nawaz Sharif, who is in London, will not escape his sentence and will return back to the country. Sharif, who is convicted of corruption charges, flew to the United Kingdom for medical treatment on Tuesday.
Pakistan's former Prime Minister Shahid Khaqan Abbasi has said that the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz or PMLN leader Nawaz Sharif, who is in London for medical treatment, will not escape his sentence and will return after his treatment. Abbasi, while talking to reporters in a video shared by the PMLN on Twitter, said, Nawaz Sharif was outside the country when he was convicted by the Accountability Court last year, and then also he had returned to the country. The former premier referred to the time when Nawaz Sharif was sentenced in the Avonfield reference for 10 years while he was in London, along with his daughter Maryam Nawaz, attending his ailing wife Kulsum Nawaz.
तो मियां नवाज़ी भी इनकी तरह नहीं है कि बाहर बैठ जाएंगे इलाज के लिए जा रहे हैं उनका हक था वापस आके जेल चले जाएंगे
नवाज शरीफ द थ्री टाइम फॉर्मर प्रीमियर कन्विक्टेड ऑफ करप्शन चार्जेस फ्लू टू द यूनाइटेड किंगडम फॉर मेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट ऑन ट्यूसडे द 69 ईयर ओल्ड लीडर वॉज रिलीज्ड ऑन बेल लास्ट मंथ फ्रॉम अ 7 ईयर सेंटेंस फॉर करप्शन आफ्टर रिपीटेड मेडिकल इश्यूज He left the country after the Lahore High Court granted him permission to travel abroad for 4 weeks, suspending the government's condition that he will have to submit indemnity bonds as a guarantee of his return.
Moving on, Pashtun activist Aurangzeb Khan Zelmay has raised concerns over the ongoing human rights violations by the Pakistani army against the Pashtuns. He said innocent Pashtuns have been targets of military operations in Pakistan's dubious war against terrorism.
Pashtun activist Aurangzeb Khan Zalmay has expressed concerns over ongoing human rights violations in Pakistan's Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and federally administered tribal areas, or Fatah. A member of Pashtun Tahafuz movement, Zalmay highlighted that hundreds of Pashtuns have been killed or are missing in so-called military action against terrorists by the Pakistan army in the Pashtun-dominated areas. He said that in order to hide brutalities against ethnic communities on its own soil, Pakistan has been creating a hue and cry over the Kashmir issue globally.
So, is war mein jo ek dubious war hai, jo Pakistan Donald Trump ne jo khud kaha hai, duniya ko pata hai, duniya ke mamalik ko pata hai, isme takriban 70 से 80,000 पश्तून जो है ना वो इसमें कत्ल हुए हैं, उसकी जाने गई है, और उसमें जो है ना हमारे 3 लाख से ज़्यादा गरे जो है ना वो मिसमार हुई है, इसमें 32,000 पश्तून जो है ना वो मिसिंग है, और इसमें 1400 जो हवातीन है पश्तूनों को वो मिसिंग है.
Activists have long accused that innocent Pashtuns have been targets of military operations, ethnic stereotyping and abductions by Pakistani security forces for past several years. They blame Pakistani army functions along with militant groups in Pashtun-dominated areas and indiscriminately uses brute force against innocent people.
In news from Afghanistan, the Taliban on Tuesday released American and Australian university professors held hostage in return for the release of 3 Taliban commanders under a swap. The move by the Taliban has raised hopes for the revival of peace talks between the Afghan government and the terror group. The Taliban released the American and Australian university professors held hostage for more than 3 years on Tuesday, US and Australian officials confirmed. The United States and Australia, while confirming the release of the professors, expressed hope that the move may improve the chances for dialogue between the Afghan government and the Taliban. American Kevin King and Australian Timothy Weeks were kidnapped in August 2016 from outside the American University of Afghanistan in Kabul, where both worked as professors. The professors were freed in return for the release of 3 Taliban commanders under a swap that had been long delayed. Afghan government's decision to carry out the swap is seen as a key to securing direct talks with the Taliban militants, who have until now refused it. Peace talks between the Taliban and the US collapsed in September after Taliban killed 12 people, including an American soldier, in a blast. More news from Afghanistan. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani on Tuesday claimed victory over the Islamic State in Afghanistan's Nangarhar, which long served as the main stronghold of the militant group. More than 600 IS fighters have surrendered with their families to be Afghanistan's government in the past few weeks.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani said on Tuesday that the security forces have obliterated Islamic State or IS militants in Afghanistan's Nangarhar. Hours after a prisoner swap with Taliban insurgents raised hopes of a lull in violence in the country. Ghani made a special trip to Nangarhar, which long served as the main stronghold of the IS, and said it is a major achievement for Afghanistan, the region, and the whole world. More than 600 fighters from the Islamic State, locally known as Daesh, have surrendered with their families to the Afghan government in past weeks. Officials said airstrikes by Afghan and coalition forces, lack of funds and low morale have forced the group to give up. Nangarhar shares a long and porous border with neighboring Pakistan. The militants planned and staged bombings from the province around Afghanistan, especially the capital Kabul. Their attacks targeting foreign nationals and minority Shiite community killed hundreds over the years.
Sri Lanka's newly elected president, Gotabaya Rajapaksa, will be visiting New Delhi on November 29th on the invitation of Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi. This will be his first overseas visit after assuming office.
Sri Lanka's newly elected president, Gotabaya Rajapaksa, on Wednesday confirmed that he will be visiting New Delhi on November 29 on Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi's invitation. Taking to Twitter, Gotabaya said he was honored to accept the invitation as his first overseas visit and to strengthen the relationship and discuss key aspects of regional security, peace and economic development. Indian Foreign Minister Subramaniam Jaishankar had on Tuesday evening met Gotabaya in Colombo and extended the invitation. Gotabaya's visit to New Delhi comes months after Prime Minister Modi visited Colombo in a goodwill gesture following the deadly Easter Sunday attacks. Gotabaya is the younger brother of former President Mahinda Rajapaksa and he oversaw the military defeat of Tamil separatists under his rule 10 years ago. He is, however, accused of war crimes for his role during the civil war in Sri Lanka.
Bhutan's Foreign Minister Tanji Dorji offered prayers at the renowned Mahabodhi Temple in India's eastern Bodh Gaya city on Tuesday. Dorji, on a week-long visit to India, aimed at strengthening bilateral ties.
Bhutan's Foreign Minister Tandi Dorji offered prayers at the renowned Mahabodhi Temple in India's eastern Bodh Gaya city on Tuesday. The Mahabodhi Temple, a UNESCO World Heritage Site, is a Buddhist temple in Bihar province. The temple complex is one of the four holy sites related to the life of Lord Buddha and particularly to the attainment of enlightenment. Dorji is on a week-long visit to India and his visit is in keeping with the tradition of regular visits and exchange of views at the highest level between India and Bhutan.
Coming here on this very auspicious day, I feel very blessed and on this day I would like to take the opportunity to wish all people all over the world and especially for the benefit of all sentient beings. As a Buddhist, we pray for the well-being of everyone.
Dorji arrived in India on Sunday afternoon and met with top Indian leadership. He met Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Tuesday and held bilateral talks aimed at bolstering ties. India and Bhutan share a unique and time-tested bilateral relationship, characterized by mutual trust, goodwill and understanding. Dorji will implain for Bhutan on Saturday.
Cherry Blossom Festival is the most colourful festival of Meghalaya province in northeastern India. The recently held Cherry Blossom Festival that celebrates the unique autumn flowering of Himalayan cherry blossoms witnessed a boost in tourist footfall.
The fourth edition of India International Cherry Blossom Festival was recently held in Shillong town of northeastern Meghalaya province. Visitors, including tourists, thronged various venues of the festival and enjoyed the unique beauty of pink and white cherry blossoms as well as Meghalaya's rich culture and tradition. Cherry Blossom Festival celebrates the unique autumn flowering of Himalayan cherry blossoms. The bloom marks the beginning of autumn in northeast India. Tourists were thrilled to witness cherry blossoms that span across the east and west Khasi Hills.
चेरी ब्लॉसम के लिए हम वही तो फर्स्ट टाइम आए हैं हम वही देखने के लिए आए ये चेरी ब्लॉसम ट्रीज में कैसा होता है ये ट्रीज कैसे दिखते हैं खास उसी के लिए हम यहाँ पे आए हैं और हम वापस बार बार आना चाहिए
एक्चुअली ये देखने के लिए मैं जापान भी गया था और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इट इज़ ऑलरेडी देयर इन इंडिया एंड क्वाइट गुड क्वाइट काफ़ी पेड़ है यहाँ पे और चेरी ब्लॉसम बहुत अच्छा सीजन अभी चल रहा है अभी
The festival aimed at attracting tourists to the hill province in autumn to witness the cherry blossoms as well as Meghalaya's traditional arts, culture and cuisine. For the first time, India and South Korea jointly celebrated the Cherry Blossom Festival in Shillong aimed at furthering cultural ties.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.